Are you talking about my junk? Oh, when they hold me on the Hail Mary. Oh, yeah, yeah. This nigga over there doing the goddamn 99 pass coverage. What the fuck?
Coach, we find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in
Sid ass. I don't know why Sid goddamn kept pinching his lineman like that. Between the Los Angeles Rams and the Denver Broncos. Every time you ran that damn dive, that shit was, oh, that's smack, come on. And then like 8 yards. This nigga pinching his line in. I ain't hating at all. I'm happy for you, brother. Just a little bit. Just a little bit, bro. I play you next week in that, what's that shit called? Pro Bowls.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Where you ass, man?
Rushers in the league. Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display.
I don't know where he passed the ball. He went out the pocket, huh?
In front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he'll take this one.
Gonna send that TNT, boy.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
That nigga Wilson, I won the Super Bowl. How I feel, bro?
Just a yard, and now it's third down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when
they're you
gotta find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
That's a P.E. You
turn into a shootout, and the offense has to keep pace.
23 yards.
That's a hit. Oh, God.
Often one of the major gifts, but don't give this guy one just yet.
You need to get Andy to fuck the fuck out of me. That shit is a pick.
Yeah, he's not that old. Hey, I'm on the wrong side of 32.
You okay? You feeling all right?
I'll be all right.
Let's get this nigga a touchdown. Man, that shit is a pick. Why am I switching players? That's crazy as fuck, bro. I'm gonna be mad as hell when I watch this stream in the morning. That was a pick, bro.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And to no one's surprise here in Denver, that'll carry through the back of the end zone for a touchback.
Damn, man. I'm mad as hell. That was a pick. Oh, my God. All right, bro. Man, shut your ugly ass up.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Now they try the right side here. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
What an advantage having an elite guy in the middle of the defensive line, because not only does he take up the space and let the linebackers run free, but he can also make plays himself, as we just saw there.
They'll set up a throw. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll look to throw now on first down. Room to run past midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. 17 yards for the Broncos there as they've got themselves a first down. A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So a first and five now after the five-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. And just a yard on the pickup there. It'll be second and four.
Well, it didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
They'll throw. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
I don't care who you put on him. He's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man. Maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football, and the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a third and 13. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They'll set up to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now, since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. And Bullock will put this one through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
This fielded at the two. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Hot, hot.
Now a handoff looking right. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Gun, gun! Set! 319! 319! Hot!
Hot! On first down, he'll drop to throw. And a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
Now they try the right side here, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, and they've got it here with a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Yeah, and that was a safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. And we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. And a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And now they face a second and six after the penalty. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. Sua Cravens up to make the stop. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. They'll go to the keeper.
I don't know about you, but I like this call. third and inches, and instead of worrying about getting it back to a running back and maybe there's some penetration from the defensive front, just go ahead and take it, move forward, and pick up the first down.
And as we say often, shows confidence in your offensive line. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Lucky 56. Hurry up, here we go. Green.
Now this time he'll look to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he lost the football. The Broncos say they have it. They do. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free, creating something good for your team.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Season and the Broncos able to show off their quick strike ability, and his kick is good. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away, and this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And they'll run it here. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Now that's how you start to get back in the good graces of your head coach. Remember, he fumbled on the last possession. How about the faith they showed him, giving him the ball again, and he repaid him, picking up the first down.
And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal game.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And able to break one tackle, but then Kuechly brought down. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
Out of the gun now on third down. And it's complete. Henry. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And there's a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Denver right after this. Three. They'll go on the ground. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Clock continuing to roll as the Rams try to get going again.
Well, with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. The Rams on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third down and 12.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
He'll look to throw. He gets it to Brown. Complete. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch, too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Back to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Flushed out right. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Gun. They'll look to throw. And Jones has it over the middle. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Play action here on first down. Bust through the tackle. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. And let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
And Bullock will put this one through. The second half upon us sooner than we bargained for. Week 7, second half, let's do it. So we're at halftime here in Denver with the Broncos leading this one. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be stopped just shy of the 25 with a penalty marker down. Here's the call. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Miles Jack there to make the tackle. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
No. Check. Patriot. Detroit.
They'll look to throw. And bringing it in right side here, Beckham. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 14 yards there and a Denver first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Got some real estate inside the 30. And all the way down to the 25-yard line. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. And on the ground they go with a running back. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. As he's down to the 2-yard line. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches, you say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. As his guys are in for six. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Rams. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the
second? Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Line of scrimmage, again, the 25, second and 10. Second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Give him 7 on the play. And that's going to bring up a third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Gun!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this only up to about the 35.
It's a gain of just three, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on fourth down.
Another down on the scoreboard, but the urge to go for it is almost irresistible here on fourth and short. Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. Oh, look at this play call. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, LA. A big play there with his 19th touchdown, his second of the game. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game. Zuerlein connects on the extra point. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Broncos offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out.
And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done.
Detroit! Hot! Gone!
They're going to look to throw. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. And it's third down.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
To it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
The Rams offense now making their way out to take over, and it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Detroit! Detroit!
Right back to him on first down. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he's a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. The Rams on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. He'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Welcome back now to Denver. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's 1st and 10. They'll look to throw here on 1st down. He's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. Sua Cravens in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. That's going to be caught. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A gain of 32 that time. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range. And guess what? They've got a shot.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on 1st and goal. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him up the middle. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's 3rd and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a 3rd time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Watching that, Barney! Barney!
And they'll run it here. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. A great play there with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. A very important extra point there, up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And the Rams got it. They bring him down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone.
Detroit,
I don't know if that
Detroit.
Was the case here, but the end result was the same.
Detroit,
no one
Detroit.
Fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. He finds Beckham complete. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as,
I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me. And I'm going to keep firing.
Gone, 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 gone.
Back to throw now on first down. He finds his target, Beckham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. And he'll go on the ground. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 25 yards the pickup there, and also a first down.
Another carry for their leader, and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've insured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits zeros.
Detroit! 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 Gone! 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 Detroit! Detroit!
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and 4. They'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. 4 yards there as they let him out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And they'll go ground game here to the tailback. The great move couldn't free him. Taken down at the 10. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll run with Foreman. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Broncos have broken the tie.
And that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced a 2-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Call it a gain of 5. And that'll make this a second down.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
Incomplete. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
He'll look to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39! Pick! Nice
pick! The win for the Broncos seemingly assured. They go down to a knee. Going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
The win for the Broncos seemingly assured. They go down to a knee.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road. But there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room. Throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for the Broncos, their good start continues as they get their record up to 4-2. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Seattle Seahawks come to town. Meanwhile, for Los Angeles, they drop just their second game so far as they fall to 5-2. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Arizona Cardinals. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
We want back ends.
Wipe my sins.
They can't win.
No new friends.
Football fast.
They sleep again.
Wake up,
the champs is in.
Champion.
We want back ends.
Wipe my sins.
Wipe it.
They can't win.
No new friends.
Football fast.
Football.
They sleep again. We wake them up.
Wake up, the champs is in.
Yeah.
Wake up. The cake up. Raise up.
Cake.
Or make us do something we don't want to.
Some.
Bite down on you. Right now on you. Juke to the left, they dodging it. Can't play the role, you flogging it. Waiting on the right for the stars in it. 4x4, double parking it. Wanna play like cars in it. Wear the right flag, they forfeit it.
stressing the problem. Julio on the post, you can't stop him. Pick it up, running back, it's no problem. I'm running the block, they gon' block him. Block pray for your arm, offset you block him. Watch the blitz on the left, we gon' block him. We some animal, yeah, we some goblin. Man to man, we gon' cover you properly. Man to man, you can't beat me impossibly. Man to man, red zone, this my highlight, my property. Do a quarter, best niggas on 4th and 3. Get your hands on the offensive block for me. I stiff him, I'm down, get off of me. I'm trucking them over, he under me.
My back is, wipe my sins,
They can't win, No new friends,
Football fans,
They sleep again, We wake them up, the champs is in, We want back ins, Wipe my sins,
wipe it.
They can't win, No new friends, Football fans, They sleep again, We wake them up, the champs is in.
I just hate the ball and I look for the open man. The zone, I'm trying to get in. Open the play, but the book of the champion. Get flipped if you trying to get in. I got the front defense, they got the end. Going for long, on first in the 10. Gotta go hard, we gotta get on. No loss or excuses, cause we gotta win. They say they sleep, must not be a fan. Get at your man.